Teachings of Venerable Master Chin Kung. The Pure Land Method is for those whose good roots have matured and are ready to become Buddhas in this very life. All forms of kindness spring from this root. It is part of our original nature. We can tell when their good roots have matured by looking to see if their faith, vows and practice are strong and unfaltering.
The key to success is diligence. The different methods prescribed by the Buddha come from the different needs of living beings. The methods spring forth naturally from the pure, unwavering heart of the Buddha without the slightest difficulty.
The Pure Land Method of cultivation is the most difficult to believe and the easiest to practice.
A cultivator can be compared to a worm eating its way out of a bamboo tree. When he practices other cultivation methods, he is like a worm eating his way up, taking a long time and tedious effort. If he practices the Pure Land Method, it's like he's eating his way sideways through the bamboo. He will attain liberation in a short time with lighter effort.
The teachings can be put to practice through two ways. First is to cultivate concentration by reciting the Buddha's name. Reciting helps us attain single-mindedness. Second is to cultivate discipline by refraining from evil doings and practicing kindness. This keeps our minds straying to improper thoughts.
True virtue and proper conduct are necessary factors in cultivation. If one cannot practice what one preaches, then regardless of how much one knows, they all become useless at the end of his life.
Peace of the world is based on peace in the family. If one can diligently follow and abide by the principle set in the guideline for beginning cultivators, Sramanera Vinaya, then one will be a sage in today's world.
We must rely upon concentration to improve our cultivation. We should keep our calm in any type of situation. The path of understanding is out of reach for sure if we cannot achieve the proper concentration.
Reincarnation is truly scary because we fall lower in the circle with each lifetime. We know of this in advance because people's minds are becoming more polluted and their actions are often inspired by evil intentions.
Disasters appear according to people's thoughts. If we want to turn the tide of destiny, we must first turn our thoughts toward kindness and compassion. We should be vegetarian, refrain from killing, and constantly be mindful of the Buddha's teachings.
Worries arise from the mind. You are wise if you do not let things worry you. Nothing and nobody can make you worry without your permission.
Accord with the people around you. Don't let your personality get in the way of your relationships with other people.
Don't worry yourself with worldly matters. Not only should we be modest when we are reciting the Buddha's name, we should be modest when doing anything.
We must enter the great teachings through one method of cultivation. Concentrated diligence is the only way to reach attainment.
If we wish to bring peace to the world, we must start by changing our evil ways. World peace stems from inner peace.
The ancients often taught of the way to reach attainment through a vase analogy. A conceited cultivator is like a vase filled to the rim with stagnant water, unable to receive a drop of the true teachings. A cultivator who still holds his own stubborn viewpoints is like an unwashed vase. Any true teachings given to him would instantly be defiled.
A cultivator who accepts the teachings but doesn't put it into practice is like a vase with a hole on the bottom. Everything it receives just leaks right back out again.
We should not be like the cultivators above, but should accept the teachings with a pure, humble heart and truly put it into practice. Only through this way are we really worth the teachings we hold.
We must cleanse ourselves of greed, hatred, and ignorance. These three poisons are the root behind all our sufferings.
We cannot attain the complete understanding because we are laden by our afflictions and bad habits. If we can practice the Pure Land Method and recite the Buddha's name, then we will be able to raise the burden and walk towards the path of understanding.
Beginners should not waste time studying different teachings. It would only obstruct them from cultivating the pure heart. Fellow cultivators of pure land should just begin by reciting Buddha's name in modesty.
Question: what should we do when we lose concentration in reciting the Buddha's name? Answer: when your thoughts scatter, you should continue reciting and not worry over this problem.
We must learn to let go and not be too stubborn with our viewpoints. If this goal can be achieved, then we will be at great ease and live with a happy, fulfilling life.
When cultivating the pure mind, less time should be spent watching television and reading magazines.
We shouldn't merely repeat the Buddha's name by mouth. We must truly be mindful of the Buddha and put his teachings into our everyday practice.
We should be conservative in what we use and be content with what we have.
Everybody is somebody we can learn from. When we see the virtues of others, we should adopt them as our own. When we see the wrongs of others, we should reflect upon ourselves for the same faults.
The spirit behind the guidelines for beginning cultivators, Sramanera Vinaya, is to impede greed and preserve our purity of mind.
The purpose of Buddha's teachings is to eradicate superstition and clear up people's misunderstandings about life.
Are you aware of the fact that our lives are getting shorter by the second?
Our goal of cultivation is to attain true happiness. True happiness is undiminishing happiness, withstanding the test of time and conditions.
Love can turn into hate. You may dislike something you adored yesterday. We should see things with eyes of equality and not let emotions control our lives.
Treat people sincerely. We should mean what we say and truly be sincere from the bottom of our hearts.
For the health of our body, we should keep it moving. In taking care of our mind, we should keep it at peace. Exercise and peace of mind are the key to living a fulfilling life.
We must be in control of our body and mind and not let them hinder our ability to enjoy life.
The greatest adversary is our own afflictions and bad habits. Attainment is at hand if we can cleanse ourselves of these impurities.
Reciting the Buddha's name is practicing single-mindedness. With single-mindedness, we will be capable of reaching the pure land.
If we learn to forgive, we will dwell in peace of mind. We must be open-minded to be a good student of the Buddha. If a cultivator can be complete in faith, vows and mindfulness of Amitabha, then he will for sure reach attainment.
Regardless of what we do, we should not give rise to anger. Wisdom springs from purity of mind.
Our hearts must be like still water in a pond. Only then can we reflect the teachings properly. The Buddha is constantly teaching. We cannot hear it because our mind is not still. We should soothe our mind by clearing it of scattered thoughts.
True cultivation is reciting Amitabha's name in modesty.
Diligently recite Amitabha's name. You may rest when you're tired. There is no pressure. After resting, continue to recite.
We should not recite the sutra for the sake of reciting it. We must understand the meaning, put it into practice and experience the truth.
How do we know when our cultivation has improved? It is when our mind has become purer, more equanimous and clearer about life.
Cultivation is not something unusual. It is part of our everyday life. Whenever we recognize and correct our faults, we are cultivating.
What are the teachings? The teachings are the proper way. The proper way is the path we follow, which is apart from all crooked and deviant views.
Wise people do not just see matters from the surface. They contemplate them thoroughly and see to the truth.
In Buddhism, love is based on wisdom. This is called compassion.